way to the ring with a combined weight of 191 kilograms. From the heart of Europe, Budapest, Hungary, here are Icarus and Dover. They are part of Amboss, the Arrows of Hungary.
Former World Tag Team Champions Icarus and Dover, the Arrows of Hungary, but in recent times they have been making headlines for different reasons entirely. They are two of the four members of the newest, most dominant faction in the wrestling world, Amboss, whose motto is reclaim, reshape, and rebuild. That is exactly what these two men and their other two allies, Laurance Roman and Robert Dreissker, intend to do: rebuild the wrestling industry in their image.
Germany, standing 1 meter 80 tall, weighing in at 85 kilograms, Elijah Blum. And his tag team partner. Ladies and gentlemen, this man is from Edison, New Jersey, USA. Standing 1.78 meters tall, weighing in at 86 kilograms, he is the ace of space, LSG!
LSG and Elijah Blum have been among those leading the charge against Amboss, trying to stop them from dominating wXw in the way that they intend to. Elijah Blum, a student at the wXw Wrestling Academy, just starting out his career. LSG, the American veteran, the ace of space, who has been a welcome addition to the training staff here at the wXw Wrestling Academy, not least because he has provided much needed backup in these efforts against Amboss. If you want to see more action like this, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell so we can bring you more great action like this on the wXw YouTube channel for absolutely free. You'll notice Dover of the Arrows of Hungary has that left arm, that left elbow taped up. That is a war wound from this ongoing battle. Blum starting out against him. He has been right at the center of that war, as I said. In fact, Amboss have tried to end that young man's career on a couple of occasions. Some of Elijah Blum's allies were able to turn the tables on Amboss. A shortcut to the top recently. They had an opportunity to do some damage to that arm of Dover. Dover's former protege, Peter Tihonyi, hesitated, didn't want to do it. So Senza Volto, the French sensation, took a steel chair out of the hands of Tihonyi and smashed it down on the arm of Dover himself. Tihonyi, though, later on that same night, in the shortcut to the top match itself, found himself in there against Dover and had no option but to do more damage to that left arm. The fact that Dover's been medically cleared to compete here is a surprise, I think, to some people. Charges into that corner. The hardcore Hungarian is the nickname, the moniker of Dover. It's a well-earned name. He has been one of the most violent, aggressive brawlers in wXw and across European wrestling in the past few years. Elijah Blum using his speed to try and catch Dover out with a twisting neck breaker. And Dover, who does look like he's having some trouble with that left arm, I think he's planning on tagging in Icarus. Seems to be some concern here from Icarus and from the referee about whether Dover is in any condition to continue. Dover hasn't made the tag. Elijah Blum came in for more, and Dover, who's basically on one arm, was able to fend off Blum, but not that time. Standing drop kick from Blum. Dover's coming back to the corner. Icarus has tagged himself in, didn't give Dover the option this time. Icarus, I think, going to try and give his partner a bit of time to recuperate. And this possible injury to Dover might be one of the few moments of weakness we've seen so far since Amboss was formed. We'd love to know what you think it would take to prevent Amboss from continuing their path of destruction through WXW. Make sure you join in the conversation in the comments. Let us know what you think about the Amboss era so far here in WXW. By the way, speaking of Pete, look at that pose from Icarus, the arrogance that we never used to see from the Arrows. I was about to say, if you want to see Peter Tihonyi, the young man who was partly responsible for the damage to Dover's left arm, if you want to see him in action, don't forget he was part of Fight Forever earlier on against the suplex assassin Alex Kane. If you missed that match, you can catch it right here on the WXW YouTube channel. Right now though, Elijah Blum having that left wrist of Icarus caught up. Icarus trying to escape, Blum not allowing him. Blum in particular has been a target of Amboss, as I said, in recent weeks. So to be able to take the fight to Icarus, one quarter of that group, is a moment that must feel pretty good for Blum. Tags in the Ace of Space, LSG. Amboss, I think, have taken particular exception to the fact that LSG has come into WXW and, as they see it, interfered in their business in recent weeks. See the disdain from Icarus towards LSG. Icarus trying to swing at him and couldn't get him. The dropkick sends Icarus down. Now a sleeper hold attempt from LSG, who gets sent to the ropes. Side headlock grabbed by Icarus, and Dover's tagged himself back in. Almost collided. The two Arrows of Hungary and LSG. I think he may have hit Dover in that left arm. Well, certainly that time the arm went into the wall of the academy here. I don't know if Dover should be in a match at all at the moment. Dover's retreated back towards the entranceway to his partner. I think Dover's done. I don't think Dover can continue. He was already pretty clearly in significant pain with that left arm, but it just smashed into the wall a couple of times. And if there was any hope of Dover being able to continue, I think that may have been put to rest. But Icarus is going to keep fighting on his own, it looks like. LSG coming out to the outside, and with a kind of like a baseball slide there, continuing the offense on the outside. And if you're liking what you're seeing here in this tag team match, don't forget to click like, subscribe, ring that notification bell. It might not be long before we're ringing the actual bell here, because it's basically 2-on-1. LSG and Elijah Blum with a member of Amboss isolated. Dover has had to return to the locker room for medical attention. Gets double teamed, the elbows. Blum's the legal man for his team, goes for the pin, gets two, and this is a real opportunity for LSG and Blum to do damage to the other member of the Arrows of Hungary, with Dover already apparently in trouble. Blum now trying to hyperextend that left arm. Well, hang on. Well, that's Robert Dreissker, the de facto leader of Amboss, apparently coming out here to replace Dover. Dreissker, I think, is saying that if Dover can't proceed, then he should be allowed to replace him. Referee is going to allow that.
Oh,
LSG and Elijah Blum not particularly pleased with that decision, because Dreissker obviously fresh. And briefly, that two-on-one advantage has now evaporated, but Icarus definitely is not 100%, because he has suffered the brunt of that two-on-one beatdown in the absence of Dover. Dreissker is still in the process of putting his ring gear on. He's putting his elbow pads on now. You can see Icarus trying to stretch out that right arm of Elijah Blum. A master of technical wrestling is Icarus. It is the attitude, the aggression from Icarus that has become his trademark as of late, as it has been for Dreissker. You just saw that cheap shot. The knee, a huge leg of Robert Dreissker, went to the lower back, the kidneys of Elijah Blum. Don't forget Robert Dreissker, the head coach of the wXw Wrestling Academy. So he knows Blum very, very well indeed. Dreissker with a big back body drop on Blum. Again, Robert Dreissker entering this match fresh, halfway through it. Blum trying to head over to LSG in the corner. Instead, Dreissker drags Blum over to the Amboss corner. Here comes Icarus once more. Icarus, the chop across the chest. The dynamic of this tag team match with the arrival of Robert Dreissker has taken another unexpected twist. Once more, if you haven't seen all of the action so far here on Fight Forever, including the match before this one, Norman Harris against Danny Frey, you can catch up with that here on the wXw YouTube channel as well. Icarus insisting on referee counting down Elijah Blum there with only a count of two. This is the strength of Amboss, even when one of their number is compromised, like Dover has been tonight. They have strength in numbers. Dreissker able to come out here to support Icarus and to continue the dominance of Amboss. Snap suplex there from Dreissker. Dreissker has done it all here in wXw. Speaking of tag team competition, Dreissker is a multiple-time world tag team champion himself. He goes for the pin there on Elijah Blum, who kicked out once more on two. You can see Blum trying to fight back. He needs desperately to get to the corner where LSG would love nothing more than to get in there against Dreissker. There's a neck breaker from Blum. The crowd here in the wXw Wrestling Academy willing Elijah Blum to make it to the corner to tag LSG. Dreissker trying to make it to Icarus and does, but Blum makes it to LSG. Both teams get reinforcements. LSG beating Icarus to the punch and beating him to the kick as well. That bicycle kick to the face. Stunner from LSG, standing in Zaguri. Icarus is on jelly legs. The ace of space heading up to the top. Dreissker shoves Icarus out of the way, takes the crossbody himself, but Icarus is the legal man. He tried to suplex LSG, who landed on his feet behind him. LSG just too fast for Amboss at the moment. Icarus gets deposited face first into the canvas. Has that stunned him enough? No. A hell of a tag team match here on Fight Forever. We're still not done. LSG brings Icarus into the corner. Tags in Iwia Blum. LSG gets launched into Icarus by his own partner. The double underhook from Blum. LSG up on that top turnbuckle. I'm not sure what they were planning, but Dreissker prevented it regardless. There's a short arm clothesline from Icarus, who tags in Dreissker. LSG is helpless. He's upside down. Oh, and a crossfire. The trademark move of the Arrows of Hungary. Dreissker will hook that outside leg, and Amboss put away Blum and LSG.
The winners of this match, Icarus and Robert Dreissker, Amboss.
Reinforcements, strength in numbers, call it what you will. And if you like what you saw in this Amboss victory, click like, click subscribe, and ring that notification bell to see more from Amboss, whose mission statement again is quite simply to reclaim, reshape, and rebuild the professional wrestling industry in their own image. The resistance against them, led by LSG. Elijah Blum, one of the most prominent soldiers in that effort. But this battle has been won by Amboss, like the majority of the battles have been since Amboss was formed. Dreissker and Icarus picking up the win for Amboss, and the question now is, what will it take, who will it take to stop Amboss? We'd love to know your opinion on that. Please let us know what you think in the comments. Don't forget, if you missed it, Norman Harris against Danny Frey is one of the matches here on Fight Forever that you can catch up on here on the wXw YouTube channel. And coming up next, it's Jacob Crane against Michael Knight here on wXw Fight Forever.